Well, welcome to 700 Club Interactive. For the last few years, we've heard about the war on Christmas. Nativity scenes have been torn down. Retailers have been banned from saying Merry Christmas. And even the Christmas tree has been targeted.
While the holiday becomes increasingly secular, Chris, Joy, and Gizmo are learning about the true meaning of Christmas this year. Here's a preview of Superbook's The First Christmas.
My word. If that stone cipher guy across the street puts one more cartoon cutout on his lawn, I just may have to break out the inflatable mistletoe reindeer.
Chris, I have your ice pitons to help you climb Price Peak. Whoa.
That's one messed up reindeer.
What in the world is going on, Crispin?
Oh, Mom, we're headed off for the Christmassy scramble up Price Peak.
That is correct, Mrs. Quantum. Chris could win. A jaw-dropping array of valuable toys and prizes that every child is dreaming about this Christmas.
Chris, before you go, can you set up the nativity?
But I already put out the Santa and the elves and the snowmen, not to mention 300 yards of Christmas lights. Besides, it's no big deal. The manger scene's just another decoration. See you, Mom. Last one into the mall's a frozen blizzard burp with slush on top.
I, for one, certainly am not a blizzard burp. No! Keep that up, Christopher Quantum, and you'll be asking for a new robot for Christmas.
Woohoo!
Look at all the cool stuff. I want to get the guitar for Toby, and, oh, I want to get the blender for Aunt Darcy.
I don't know. I think it might just have to be a smaller Christmas this year.
Attention all you Mega Mall Christmas shoppers. If Icicle the Snowman chooses your lucky number, you'll get a chance to climb Prize Peak. And the winning ticket is 2, 3, 4, 6, 3!
I won! Joy! Gizmo! All those gifts are mine!
Ha ha!
Ah, this is what Christmas is all about!
Superbook!
Hey! My winning ticket! Superbook, I can't go now! I gotta climb Price Peak!
Well, that was a taste of our latest episode, The First Christmas. And if you want to get this, what we're asking for is help with the production costs of the entire series. So we're asking you to join the Superbook DVD Club. It's a monthly club. We'll send to you every 4 to 6 weeks the new episodes as they're completed. And what we're asking for is you to sign up for $25 an episode to help with the production costs. We're in production now of 26 episodes. This is the fourth to be completed. So if you want to get involved in helping the production costs for the entire series, plus having the stories of the Bible for your children, your grandchildren, they can have that this Christmas season. So call us if you want to get involved in this. 888-777-1999. And for your gift of $25, we'll send you the latest episode, The First Christmas. You have to order this by December 5th in order to get delivery by Christmas. Make a great Christmas gift. Not only will we send you one in the DVD case, we've got two others in these little slip cases you'll send as well that we want you to give away to friends and family to say, here's something for your children that will be a real blessing to them this Christmas. It's the Christmas story, the story of the birth of Jesus. So if you'd like it, just go to CBN.com. There's a special landing page where you can sign up for the DVD Club, or just call us, 888-777-1999, and say, yes, I want to be part of the DVD Club for Superbook.
Well, I want to know what happens next.
You don't know what happens next?
You're just leaving me here?
I'm leaving you hanging.
Okay.
We aren't going to show another excerpt.
Okay, I'll stick around then.
Stick around.
But up next, we're going to be showing you more of Superbook's latest episode. It's The First Christmas. Find out what happens when Chris, Joy, and Gizmo come face to face with King Herod.
The
in time for Christmas.
And the winning ticket is...
I won! All those gifts are mine! This is what Christmas is all about.
Give the gift you know and trust to those you care about the most.
Superbook!
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, The First Christmas, and two copies to share with others, all for your gift of $25.
Go search for the young child, and when you've found him, bring back word to me.
Do you think that they could be the ones who are having the baby King Herod was talking about?
Superbook is giving us front row seats for the very first Christmas ever.
Your membership means the fun and learning keep coming every month. With your continued monthly support, you'll receive three copies of each new episode.
Jesus has been born. Come, let us adore him.
Superbook DVD Club. It's a brand new way to give a strong spiritual foundation to the children you love in a way they'll love to watch. Superbook, The First Christmas, available now.
When you want the latest information about your health, when you have questions about handling your finances, when you need prayer and inspiration to live a more abundant life, and when what's happening in the world impacts your community and your family, turn to the 700 Club for analysis and insight into the events of the day. The 700 Club, next.
The 700 Club, see it as never before. The stories, the places, the people. The 700 Club, now in HD. Look into the eyes of the people you've helped. Experience what God is doing in the world today in high definition. The 700 Club, now in HD.
Today we've been giving you a glimpse of Superbook's latest episode, The First Christmas. In this next clip, Chris, Joy, and Gizmo are taken back in time to meet three wise men and one angry king. Watch this.
Giz, where are we?
In the land of very hard floors.
You, servants, bring the dinner platters into King Herod. Hurry!
Three wise men traveling over such a great distance. Remarkable.
Where is he who has been born King of the Jews?
For we have seen his star in the east.
And have come to worship him.
Perhaps my priests can assist you.
There is a prophecy, a ruler arising in Bethlehem.
Go search for the young child, and when you've found him, bring back word to me that I may also come and worship him.
A king of the Jews? Never.
No infant born in my realm shall grow up to challenge my reign.
What are we going to do?
What can we do, Joy?
It looks like Superbook has an idea of his own.
Could you please assist us? We must find shelter from this storm.
Do you think, I don't know, that they could be the ones who are having the baby King Herod was talking about?
The most joyous news I could have ever imagined was first told to me by an angel.
Do not be afraid, Mary. You will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son. Of his kingdom, there will be no end.
You do not have family in Bethlehem. Move along.
Aren't you worried? You know, about Mary and the baby with all that's going on? What if you're wrong? I mean, what if God doesn't come through?
You heard. He told Mary his son would reign over the house of Jacob forever.
Maybe so, but it's Herod's plan that still worries me. Uh-oh, here comes trouble.
When is she due to have the child?
Soon.
Try the last tent down the road. I hear they have room. Perhaps you can stay the night.
Thank you.
You want the savior of the world to be born in a stable?
History's in the making, mister.
Do you want it or not?
Do you hear that?
Look at us! Superbook is giving us front row seats for the very first Christmas ever!
And you can have those same front row seats for your children, your grandchildren, just by saying, yes, I want to help with the production costs. I want to be a part of Superbook. We're asking you to join the Superbook DVD Club. How much is it? Well, it's $25 an episode. And when you join the club, we'll not just give you one DVD. We'll give you three so that you have two that you can give away to your friends and loved ones this Christmas season. Share the Christmas story. Share the true meaning of Christmas. It's all about the birth of Jesus, and you can have a front row seat to it. So sign up for the club. Just call us, 888-777-1999, or you can log on to CBN.com. We've got a lot more than just the DVD. We have this wonderful website, superbook.tv, where children can learn more about each episode that's been released so far, plus a 30-day devotional, lots of games, activities for them. So there's plenty of fun throughout the Christmas season. So if you want to be a part of it, just go to superbook.tv. But join the club. Do it now. Call us, 888-777-1999. Terry?
Well, still ahead, a selfless little boy is struck with a life-threatening illness. Find out what happened when people from all over the world joined in prayer for his recovery after this.
It's hard to believe it's been 8 years since I made that commercial. And now I'm a 10-year survivor.
Today's a special day, a big milestone to me. I'm out here riding my horse, appreciating every minute of it.
My life changed the day I was diagnosed with cancer. It was hard when I was lying in the hospital and didn't know if anybody survived pancreatic cancer, that I decided,
if I survive this, I want to offer hope to somebody else
and to show them that there are people out there like Cancer Treatment Centers of America who can make a difference.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and late-stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com. You'll be able to see our treatment results for many types of cancers and how they compare to national averages. You can also check for participating insurance plans.
The doctors looked over what they needed to do for me, but the decision was always mine.
At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, every resource, every one of us, everything we do every day is focused on you, our patient. Your treatment, your healing, your survival.
After cancer now, I just appreciate life so much more. I appreciate the little things.
Being able to carry a bucket of water for my horse again was like winning a marathon. Not 1 hour goes by that I don't stop and think about how fortunate I was to have found CTCA.
Our teams of physicians, clinicians, and nurses are highly experienced and dedicated. We use state-of-the-art technology and give you innovative treatment options you may not even know exist. You'll also experience whole-person compassionate care here, unlike anything you've seen before.
When I talk to people and they said, oh my gosh, a 10-year survivor, I can't believe it. Life is good and I just appreciate it totally. I'm doing things I never dreamt I would do.
Call or go to cancercenter.com today to learn more about our unique approach to state-of-the-art cancer care. Cancer Treatment Centers of America, care that never quits.
Carter Ranson is a boy with a big heart. He loves helping other people, and when Carter needed help himself, thousands of people answered the call.
It was the summer of 2001. The Ranson family was making their way through Texas on vacation when mom Jennifer noticed her 7-year-old son Carter was crying.
I looked back and I saw Carter and he just had tears streaming down his face. And I'm like, Carter, are you okay? I mean, I thought the kids were fighting or something. I'd missed something. And he said, Mommy, we have to do something to help these hungry people. We have to do something.
The family had just passed through the small destitute town of Deweyville.
God started working something in him and in his heart, and he would not let it go.
Back home after vacation, Carter called a meeting with his parents.
He started describing to us something that had to be a God idea. And so he goes, what I want to do is to make Thanksgiving food boxes and bring them to Deweyville.
So Carter came up with a plan. He sent a letter to everyone he knew asking for donations. He also worked for his dad in the family lighting business.
That year, we took 25 food boxes to Deweyville. So when the people leave, they really have everything that it takes to have a wonderful Thanksgiving dinner, just like, you know, we would have at our home.
Carter put together food boxes for the next 3 years, but his plans came to a halt when Jennifer got a call from her husband, Tim.
He was like, Carter's sick, and he really has really bad diarrhea and is throwing up. When I got home, I came into the house, and Carter was in the restroom, and I went into the bathroom, and when I saw what was happening myself, it was very different. What I saw was just I was like, something is not right. Something is not right.
Jennifer and Tim rushed 10-year-old Carter to the emergency room. Several difficult days passed before doctors found out what was wrong.
They came in one day and they said that it was E. coli, and it was the worst type of E. coli that you could get. There's nothing you can do. You can't treat for E. coli. You have to just treat the symptoms that it produces. And so for over, I guess, a week and a half or so, Carter still was just violently ill all the time. We would just sit there and pray. And just pray that our little boy would be okay, that our little boy would walk out of that hospital.
After 2 weeks in the hospital, the Ransons became desperate.
It was literally several times an hour that we were dragging the IV pole into the bathroom and helping him. And he was just so sick.
There was no relief for Carter, and he couldn't eat. Then the news got worse.
The first time the word fatal came out of the doctor's mouth, I couldn't believe it. I have no clue what else he said, because that's the only word that I heard.
Tim sent out an urgent email asking for prayer. That night, a group gathered at church to pray.
Those hundreds of people that loved God passionately joined their prayers with the other hundreds of people, thousands of people probably, that were praying around the world. And we believe that God gave us our miracle.
Jennifer went home for the first time in weeks to try and get a decent night's sleep. The next morning, the phone rang.
Tim called me and said, Carter wants Krispy Kreme donuts. And I'm like, huh? The child had not asked for anything to eat in weeks, And I'm like, he wants what? And I'm like, yeah. He goes, stop and get some. The nurses said he has to eat some other things first, but bring the donuts. And I'm like, what? Believe it. And I walked back into the hospital room with the Krispy Kreme donuts. And as I walked into that room, my little boy was back. And God had given us the miracle that we had prayed for.
3 days later, the Ransons walked out of the hospital. Now 13, Carter has shown no side effects from the infection.
It revealed to me that there's a need. When I was in the hospital, I had very good health care. And I knew that the people all around the world that don't have that, and they're sicker than me. And so I feel like God wants me to help. God told me through E. coli that there's a real need in the world and that we needed help.
After Carter had E. coli, it was amazing what God did in his life. It was amazing to see the faith. It just was stretched so far when he was in the hospital. It was amazing to see his passion for God and the things of God grow.
I definitely want to be a light, and I want people to see that Jesus lives in me, and I want to make a difference. And I definitely want to see that people see the love of God in me. God loves you, and that he definitely has a purpose for your life. And he is always with you through every dark spot, and he is always going to love you no matter what. There's nothing you can do to make God not love you.
Well, Carter, that kind of sums up the whole message for all of us, doesn't it? When you're in a dark place, God can help you. He's the only one who can really help you. He loves you. You matter to him. He's got your best interest in mind. It's time to pray for all of you.
It is. You watch this story and you just think, the world is not worthy of Carter Ransom. But here he is trying to do good for other people.
Yeah.
And he's got that going. He's, mm-hmm. he's saying, I want to do that. And then the next thing you know, he's facing a life-threatening illness. Now, a lot of people start thinking, where was God in that? And you start asking the question, why? Why did this happen to Carter? Good things should have been happening to him because he was doing good. Well, here's a promise, and it's from Jesus. And he says, in this world, you'll have suffering. And we need to take that seriously and understand that it's not God's will for that to happen. Jesus is just stating the fact of what has happened to the world since the fall. And the earth literally is under a curse. So therefore, there's suffering, there's trouble, there's persecution, there's trials of our faith, all these kinds of things. Now, Jesus said in the Lord's Prayer, this is how we're supposed to pray, Father, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, start thinking about heaven. Is there anybody sick up there? Is there anybody in need? Is there anybody lonely? Is there anybody having heartache? Any E. coli? Well, no. And that's the place where God's perfect will is being perfectly done all the time. So we're supposed to pray for God's will to be done. You know, he says that he's not going to save us from the world. He wants us to be in the world. He wants us to be salt and light. And when we go, we need to understand not everything that's going to happen to us is God's will. But if we pray and literally command his will to be done on earth as it is in heaven, then we have what we ask for. And all we need to do that is just a little bit of faith, just a mustard seed of faith. And what are we supposed to have faith in? We're supposed to have faith in God. And if we get wrapped up in these questions of, is it God's will, and where's God's sovereignty, and why is this happening to me, and all these other kinds of questions, we're going to miss the greatest thing, which is have faith in a loving God who nothing can separate you from his love, and he wants his perfect will to be done perfectly in our life. He wants us to pray his will down on earth. Now, what happened to Carter can happen to you. He had a lot of people praying for him. Right now, you have a lot of people praying for you. We have a chat room full of people. We have an audience full of people all saying, okay, I'll stop what I'm doing and pray for others and pray for others in need and pray specifically that God's will would be done on earth as it is in heaven. So, right now, if you have a financial need, if you have a need in your family, if you have a need for physical healing, if there's no other solution but God, right now, stop. And let's agree in prayer. And let's join with the prayer that Jesus has asked us to pray. Father, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And we understand that your love and your perfect love and you desire no bad thing to ever happen to any one of us. And you desire us to bring your will to earth. So we have faith in you, not in our prayer, not in us, just in you. We have faith in God, and we believe God wants to work on earth and take care of these problems and take care of his children. And all we have to do is pray it in. So if this is for you, if you're sick, lay a hand on that area of the body that needs healing. If you need a financial miracle, I really believe in faith just to pray over a purse, over a wallet, over a bank account, and let's break off any bondage that seeks to rob and steal and destroy you. If you have prayer needs in your family, if you got a picture of them, let's just pray and just believe God and believe God for them. The Bible says if two or more agree touching anything, it shall be done. And so we're going to agree, and you're going to touch, and God's going to do the rest. Let's pray. Lord, we just lift the needs of the audience to you right now. And as people in an act of faith are laying their hands on that area of the body that needs healing, we turn to you, the author and the finisher of our faith. We turn to your sacrifice on the cross, and we understand that by your stripes we were healed. We understand that you have paid the price. We understand that the curse is broken for us, that you became a curse so that we would no longer be cursed. And so, Lord, we believe now, and we believe on you, and we have faith in you. And so now we say together, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Kingdom of God, come to this body, come to these finances, come to this family now. And in Jesus' name, be healed, be restored, be reconciled now. We agree together, touching these things, and we proclaim it out loud. And we believe now in Jesus' name. There's someone, you've been in an automobile accident. The right part of your skull, I think, went into the window or into a doorpost behind you. and it's a severe injury, and God is healing, and He's restoring you right now. In Jesus' name, no more pain, no more headaches, no more confusion. In Jesus' name, be healed and be made whole.
There's someone else. You have a spinal issue. Don't know how this happened to you, but something's badly out of alignment. I mean, it has everything to do with how your hips sit right in your body and how your legs feel. God is touching you and healing you from the top of your spine all the way down to the bottom of it. So He just aligns all of that for you.
Someone with eye difficulty and eye strain is causing recurring headaches, and you're at a loss, doctors are at a loss, and God's healing your eyes now. He's taken away all that irritation, all that problem in focusing, and in Jesus' name, be restored and be healed now. You're just feeling it leave your temples. All that pain just left you now, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Someone else with a gastrointestinal problem that you've had for many, many years. God is touching. You're just going to feel a warmth over your abdomen now, and it'll be gone.
Lord, we thank You, for You are the healer. You are the restorer. You are the reconciler. And You are our all in all, our the one that we look to. Be with us now. Do it now, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
If you've been touched by God, we always rejoice in what God is doing in the world today, and we want to share your story with others, so share it with us. Call us, 888-777-1999, and we remind you, we're here for you. Where if you need someone to agree with you in prayer, touching anything, it's our honor to pray for you, and we're here 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So if you want someone to agree with you in prayer, call us, 888-777-1999. I believe we have a prayer chat request. Michelle, do you have that?
Yes. Gordon, Charlie on chat says he needs prayer for his grandson. The grandson has a doctor's appointment today. He has a lazy eye. He can't see properly. He's asking us to pray for a good outcome for this appointment.
All right, pray for him.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we lift up this grandson to You. We thank You that You can bring total healing, and so we bind up every spirit of infirmity, and we loose Your total healing. We thank You for Your will being done in his life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. All right, I think we've got some inbox questions that came in. And here it is. Chris writes, my sister-in-law is a Christian, but we kind of worry about her homeschooling. Is that legal?
Yes, it is legal. In fact, lots and lots of people do that. We happen to live in an area that has very strong support of and involvement in homeschooling. And to be perfectly honest with you, most of the kids I know that are homeschooled are incredibly well-adjusted, very intelligent, and go on to do very successfully in college and university.
All right. They're even being admitted to the Ivy League, so
yes,
maybe
yes.
I'll mess them up. But if you're worried about what your child is going to be exposed to in the public school system today, you know, you can take action. And we've gotten it wrong. If we think it's illegal, no, it's perfectly legal, and the kids come out great. Mm-hmm. Well, the next question, Dina writes in, my children won't baptize my grandchildren. Will they still go to heaven if something were to happen to them before they're old enough to decide for themselves?
Well, we don't get into heaven because of baptism. We get into heaven because of the blood of Jesus. And so, I baptized my children to please my grandparents and my parents. But really what I was doing in my heart was dedicating them to the Lord and making a commitment as a parent that we would raise them to know God and to walk in His ways. And then at an age of accountability where they understand, they make their own personal commitment. And that's how we all come into the kingdom, understanding and making that commitment and knowing Jesus.
In the Jewish tradition, the age of accountability. The reason we have a mm-hmm. bar and bat mitzvah is at age 12, you were presented mm-hmm. to the temple as now you're accountable to the law. And that meant before that, you weren't accountable.
Right.
So, yay.
Yay. Yeah. Oh, to yay. Be 10.
Well, some people say I'm still 5. Yeah. Anyway, that's all the time we have for this program. We leave you this word from Proverbs chapter 20. The godly walk with integrity. Blessed are their children after them. God bless you. We'll see you again.